Hello everyone, today we are going to discuss concept of interference and undercutting from the unit of spur gear. So let's start with the definition first. What is interference? When tip of the pinion undercuts the root of the gear is nothing but the interference, or vice versa. So here in this video or in this picture you can see easily, when tip touches with the root of the another gear, then that surface may be wear out. So this condition we called as interference. So with definition, here we have, when tip of the tooth undercuts the root on its mating gear, it known as interference. So let's see this concept of interference again by using of this diagram. Now here we have gear 1 and gear 2 is in mesh, and the addenda of gear 1, right now it is passes, let us say, from point L, but now we are going to increase this addendum up to point N. So addendum of gear 1 is now passes from the point of tangency, that is point N. If we further increase this addendum, then it is inside the base circle. Means what happened? If we increase the addendum of gear 1, it will be inside the base circle, means it is in contact with non-involute gear of the gear 2, then there is an interference. It means this is the limiting value for addendum. So in similar manner, we can increase the addendum of gear 2 up to the point of tangency only. If we further increase this addendum, then it is inside the base circle, means it is in contact with non-involute gear, means there is a interference. So as we know, interference is negative phenomena, so there are the methods in order to avoid the interference. Firstly, minimum number of teeth in order to avoid the interference. For that, see this example. Now here we have some specification for gear. Each circle radius is R, then addendum circle radius is R plus M, that is R plus A, because we know that standard addendum is equal to 1 module. So it is R plus A, or here they mention R plus M. Addendum circle radius is R minus of 1.157 module. See, here we have a standard profile. In this profile, as you can see, addendum is equal to 1 module and addendum is equal to 1.157 module. Means when we need to calculate addendum circle radius, it is this R plus module, and when we need to calculate addendum circle radius, this is R, that is base circle radius, minus of 1.157 module. So that here we found this formula for addendum circle radius. It is R minus of 1.157 module. Then base circle radius is R cos of phi, and phi is the pressure angle. So we know that M is equal to D by T and R is equal to MT by 2. So by using of this relation, suppose we have a standard involute gear, that let us say pressure angle is 20 degree, and we have 18 and 15 number of teeth. Now let's just do the calculation for this two number of teeth. So here we calculated each circle radius, that is mentioned over these two tables, then addendum circle radius, addendum circle radius, and base circle radius. So here we have the calculation for gear 1, where we have number of teeth 18, and gear 2, where we have number of teeth 15. Now as you can see clearly, the base circle and addendum circle for gear 1 and gear 2. So see what is the difference in both two values. In case of gear 1, the addendum is more than base circle, and in case of gear 2, addendum is less than base circle. Now let's see this figure. Here we have base circle. Let us say this is case 1, when we have T is equal to 80, and this is case 2, when we have T is equal to 15. Okay. So see, in case 1, dedendum is more than addendum. So here is the case 1. So let me draw a dedendum which is more than, sorry, it is more than base circle. Now as I have drawn the dedendum above the base circle, this is dedendum. So what we can say that tooth profile start right here. Let us say this is the tooth profile. So it is start from the base circle. Now in second case, dedendum is less than base circle. So here I need to draw dedendum is inside the base circle. So as okay, now see, the involute profile is start above the base circle and below that there is a fillet curve. Okay, so what happened in this case, this curve is non-involute curve. So if this curve is non-involute, then chances of mating here comes in contact with the non-involute curve is increases, means here is a chances of interference. But see, in this case the whole curve is involute because dedendum is above the base circle, so here we can reduce the chances of interference because the involute tooth profile is increased because base circle is less than the dedendum circle radius. So in this way, if we select minimum number of teeth in order to avoid the interference, we can able to avoid the interference. But below the minimum number of teeth, then there is a interference. Now secondly, when we increase the pressure angle, as you can see here, we have the standard tooth profiles. So firstly we have the 14.5 degree, and then we modify it with increasing pressure angle, so we have the 20 degree involute tooth profile. So in case of 20 degree, tooth profile becomes standard and here the interference problem is less. So see how the pressure angle is affect on interference. Right now see, we have the two mating gears O1 and O2, then here we have the common contact point P, which is pinch point. Then let us say this is the common tangent. So angle between common normal and common tangent is pressure angle. Now see, if I need to increase this pressure angle, what I am going to change, so this common normal we are shifted with certain distance. So common normal is always common tangent to base circle. So as we increase the pressure angle, we reduce the base circle. Similarly, we will reduce the base circle for gear 2 also, so that this common normal become tangent to the base circle. Now if we increase the pressure angle, what does it means? Base circle will be reduced, and as we know, above the base circle there is an involute tooth profile. So if we reduce the base circle, then we increase the involute tooth profile, and if standard tooth profile get increases, then there is a no interference. So we have discussed two methods in order to avoid interference. Firstly, we increase the pressure angle. Secondly, we design the tooth profile for minimum number of teeth. Then also the method called of undercutting is used to avoid the interference. But in that case, gear become weak at its base. So again, undercutting is negative phenomena. So next is tooth stubbing. So in that case, portion of teeth of tooth is removed so that we can prevent that tip is in comes in contact with non-involute curve. That is the next method. And at the end we have changing of center distance, but that center distance can be slightly changed for involute tooth profile in order to avoid interference. So in this way we can avoid the interference in involute tooth profile. Thank you for watching video. Now let's move towards the gate questions. Here we have the questions based on the interference. Try to find out the answer and comment it. Thank you.